Hey guys, what is up? Josh Short here from Edit Video Faster. This tutorial is on how to pop or jump any sort of layer in After Effects across the screen. So instead of something gradually moving across the screen, it'll pop into place. So in After Effects, there's a million different ways to do pretty much anything. I'm going to show you how to use hold keyframes to do this. In my mind, this is the simplest way to do this. And you can use hold keyframes for not just the position property, which I'm going to show you in just a second. You can use for opacity, for scale, for any of these zillion other things we have going on here in After Effects. But for today, let's show you how to jump these objects, you know, across the screen without having them kind of move, you know, back and forth. So here in my composition, I have a background layer and I have the shape layer. I have the position property open. You can just select the layer, hit the P key to do that. I'm going to set a keyframe here, move further down in time, move this guy around further again, move it again. So as you can expect, across time, this thing's just going to move. Instead of that, we want it to jump. Boom, 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 or boom, boom, boom. So what you want to do, select all the layers select all the keyframes on the layer, right-click any of the keyframes, and go to Keyframe Interpolation. From here, change the Temporal Interpolation, change that to Hold, and then click OK. Now you see the little icons instead of that diamond shape. Now it's kind of like a half diamond with a, you know, straight edge on the end of it. So when we scrub through, instead of the shape gradually moving across the screen, it's going to pop between the different keyframes. So it's going to stay at that, you know, at this number here. And then when we get to the next keyframe, it's going to jump to wherever we had it set. So again, we can use this for scale. Let's just use this text layer here that I have. And if we want to scale the text instead of doing, you know, the font size, well, let's say we want to scale it. We can use scale here. And let's shrink it down and go up. And then the same thing, select the layers or select the keyframes on the layer, right click. Keyframe interpolation, and then under temporal interpolation, change that to hold, click OK. We see the keyframe icons change, and now my text is going to pop on the different scales. So I hope you found this helpful. I did get a YouTube comment about this topic. So shout out to the viewer who left me that comment. So if you do have questions, please leave them below. It gives me inspiration for making more videos like this one. I know it's been a minute since I've had a new video. So I hope you've been well, not going anywhere, and I'll see you all around in the next video. Go drink some water. Bye.